Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we are going to talk about the step-by-step process of getting yourself registered as an engineer in Canada. We are also going to talk about the documents you will need for the process and the eligibility requirements. So without wasting any time, let's get right into it. So if you are an engineer and you want to pursue your career in the field of engineering in Canada, then there are two options. You can either apply to become an EIT or you can apply to become a professional engineer, that is a P.Eng. Now, what is the difference between an EIT and a P.Eng? Both the designations, EIT and a P.Eng, will need you to have engineering degree. But in order to qualify to become a P.Eng, you need to have 4 years of relevant engineering work experience with at least 1 year of Canadian work experience supervised by a P.Eng. Now, if we talk about the process of getting yourself registered as an EIT in the province in which you are operating, you don't need to satisfy any sort of work experience. So a person with just an engineering degree and zero work experience can also qualify to get registered as an EIT. You just need to satisfy the educational requirements. So the only educational requirement you need to satisfy is that you need to have a 4 years bachelor degree either in applied science, engineering, geoscience, or science or technology. If you do not have an undergraduate degree in engineering from an accredited university program, you may be assigned some academic examinations or an interview. Now let's talk about the documents you will require for this process. First of all, I would like to point out that the complete process is online. Now, if we talk about the documents, you need to have 2 pieces of government-issued ID. Some provincial body may also ask you to get your ID signed by a professional engineer. You will also need to get all your transcripts sent from your university to the provincial body who is going to assign you your EIT designation. If your degree is not accredited, you might also need to send your ECA report, which is your educational credential assessment. Now, if your degree is not from Canada, then you might also need to submit a self-evaluation checklist. In this checklist, you need to clarify all the courses that you did when you pursued your engineering from outside of Canada, and you also need to clarify each and every topic that you completed in each course. And you need to send that self-evaluation checklist along with the application. If you have finished your master's or PhD, then you need to also submit a copy of your thesis. Last but not the least, if you are also registered as an engineer in any other province of Canada, you also need to declare that and submit relevant documentation to make the overall process a lot smoother. So if we talk about the province of BC, then we have the EGBC body, which is the Engineer and Geoscientist of British Columbia. They have provided a self-assessment tool, which is very helpful for you to qualify. So once you submit your online application, you will face one of the 3 possible scenarios. The first scenario is whatever education you have completed and you have provided the relevant documentation is good enough, your education is valid, and you will be issued an EIT designation. The second scenario is your education is valid, but you still are missing some courses. In that case, you will have 2 options. You can either give exams just for those courses, or you can give 1 exam, which is a fundamentals of engineering exam, which is an exam that is going to satisfy all your educational requirements. Once you clear the FE exam, you will be issued your engineer in training designation. The third possible scenario is the education that you have finished and the relevant documentation that you have submitted is not satisfactory. In that case, you have to study in Canada to get registered as an EIT. Sometimes a combination of education and some relevant work experience can be helpful to overcome the educational requirements, but it will again depend on your application and the provincial body where you are applying to get registered as an EIT. So it will vary from one application to another. So friends, I really hope you liked this video and found it helpful. If you have any questions, please get back to us. For more videos like this, please subscribe to our channel. Till the next video, take care. Bye-bye.